So I first began having symptoms of OCD when I was maybe 4 or 5 years of age, and I was diagnosed in high school, so around 2007. Since then, I've seen about 13 to 14 healthcare professionals in 3 different cities. I've tried, I think at last count, 13 to 15 different medications.
Most of my patients who are considering deep brain stimulation have been suffering for years, and they've tried treatment after treatment. They've had providers tell them that they must want to be sick because they aren't getting better.
OCD for me was ubiquitous. I had obsessions about just about everything, and so my rituals were in an attempt to try to reduce that anxiety. There were a lot of different rituals, but I think the most debilitating ones was I would not use any restroom besides my own. As a resident, I was struggling. Resident shifts can range anywhere from 12 to 28 hours. And so not being able to use public restrooms at that time was very problematic. My supervisors quickly noticed that what I was doing was not sustainable and literally saved my life by plugging me in with Rachel Davis. Pretty quickly, she realized that I was probably a candidate for more advanced treatment.
We're one of just a few centers in the world that offer deep brain stimulation for OCD as a treatment option. Programming is an intensive process as it exists now. I meet with my patient for 3 days in a row, and we try hundreds of different settings. And by adjusting settings, you can activate different electrode contacts. By doing so, you're stimulating slightly different areas of the brain. When you're stimulating the right contact at a good combination, patients tend to feel an improved mood, lessening of anxiety, improved energy, and for many, this is the first time they've felt better in years and years.
The emotions range from sadness to giddiness to feeling like you could conquer the world to anxiety, and we had to find a good set of stimulation settings that really helped me uplift my mood but also deal with that anxiety and the OCD better.
Exposure and response prevention basically means you expose yourself to your fears and then you don't do your rituals. So it sounds simple, right? But the person with OCD knows their fears don't make sense at all. But because it feels so real, it still feels impossible not to engage in rituals. Moksha had limited ability to engage in exposures before DBS.
Since the surgery, my exposure response prevention therapy has really taken off. I'm able to go into public restrooms, I can throw things away in public garbages, touch dirty objects, not wash my hands. I literally feel like I was reborn after the procedure.
For me, it is so amazing to see someone just begin to experience relief and have a little bit of hope. I get to work with them to help them figure out what do they want their life to look like? How do they build meaning? How do they build purpose? Where do they go from here? And it's really pretty cool to be able to be a part of that.
I had logically, cognitively given up hope. You know, I didn't think I would ever get better. And I didn't know this miraculous treatment for me was on the horizon. So don't give up hope.